been doing so hot lately, but it's now or never, pretty much. It's the last day of the season for most places around here for rabbits and squirrels and grouse and all that, you know, for general small game hunting. So I'm going to head up 2.5 hours north to Patrick's, where there's still small game, and we're going to hunt this morning, and then I'm going to leave around noon or so to help my family out. Breakfast of champions. 3:30 in the morning. Time to get rolling. Time to dust this old girl off. Come on, honey, it's time. Franchi Affinity 20 gauge. Alright. 140 miles. For some rabbits, hopefully. Hope this is worth it. I don't think I'm even 1/10 away there. I feel like topping it off because I'm gonna have to at some point. Alright, got Patrick, and this whole side of this hill here is the rabbit spot. Looks sick. These could be slugs for all I know. Grabbed a pile of them. Yeah.
So what we'll do is I'll have you stay on the lower part, I'll go up high.
Okay.
We'll leave all this bottom untouched for now. But we'll walk this one a little up.
I knocked him. It was a far shot for improved. I definitely nicked him. He's in this. Well, you didn't lie, man. First minute or so, a rabbit. Heck yeah. He's, look at my gun. He's right in that one right there.
Yeah, I know. I saw where he
went. Okay. Holy cow, this is gonna be a slaughter. You missed? Dude, the drive was worth it just for this. Just for those 2 minutes. I don't know, I was shooting at a flicker of movement. Put it right on him. Oh, I see something in there. Yep, I got him. Gotcha. Get over here. Oh. Dang it. Crazy, dude. Oh my gosh. All right, got him out here. First rabbit. Patrick's already missed like three. I haven't shot in a long time too, buddy. I've been sick. What? Are you kidding me? I couldn't buy action like that back where I live. What? Really? I'm just looking through the brush, seeing if I can find one sitting there.
I'll go, but we'll go back through it.
Yo, yeah, show this for the vlog, man. That's rabbiting right there. Heck yeah. That's the spirit. You see it?
Yeah.
I didn't see it. You get him? Shoot. I tailed him. Didn't shoot far enough ahead. Jeez. That was loud, man. That must have been halfway towards me. Huh. Nice. Man, so many of these trees are chewed down by rabbits. It's insane. I've never seen that before. Like, every tree I can point to, look at all the bark gone from the rabbits stripping it in the winter. It's crazy.
From the hip.
Nice, from the hip.
Yeah.
Well, you got me. Crawl under this tree. I've just been like carefully looking through every brush pile for a rabbit shape so I can blow its head off. I'm pretty hot. Okay. Something in there. Did you lose them?
One for 11.
And I'm 1 for 2. There's something died in here.
Rabbit.
I don't see it. How did I miss that? You gotta be kidding me, man. I shot right behind him.
Go check, make sure I saw it on the roll.
What? I hear him.
You did?
Yeah.
Is he that thing making that noise?
Yeah. Dude, that was like a 40-yard shot.
You got him?
Yeah.
Shoot, I didn't get him.
Your second shot went right behind him.
That's all right. Nice job, man. Second one of the day.
Little one.
You're beating me now, but you've seen a lot more than me, too.
That one's a little peppered.
That's okay. Give him the triple tap. Another? You're seeing so many more than me. I'm trying to pull a thorn out of my sock here and you're seeing one. Huh? That's it? Okay. Okay. Whew. Yes, man. That's the most fun I've had rabbit hunting in years. Years ago, my spot used to be like that, and then people came in with their beagles and whatever and ruined it. All right, we're going pigeon hunting next, and then maybe more rabbit hunting after. Oh, man. Oh, we're at the pigeon place, but all I see is geese. Holy cow. Look at them all. It's like 1,000. That's incredible. There's so many.
Told you it's like the best waterfowl spot ever.
Wow. Look at them all. Oh my gosh, man. Well, here we are, waiting in our pigeon spot for them to fly over. Nothing yet. Alright, we're blowing this joint. I'll have to hit more rabbit spots. Alright, time for the long walk in to the next spot. We're going rabbit hunting. Maybe we'll see a squirrel or something along the way. Man, it is so nice out here. Just walking this in a t-shirt and really thin pants. It's beautiful out. So we're finally here, man. What's the game plan?
Well, I like to hunt these fields in loops. I'll do one edge,
mm-hmm.
come up, and follow up this edge.
Okay.
Then I'll do the next same thing with the next field. There's about 4 or 5 fields here that we can do this with. And generally, I just focus on these larger briar patches.
Yeah.
And they usually hold the most rabbits.
And I'm gonna go in on the inside of you?
You're going to be on the inside, yeah.
All right.
Generally, the rabbits run out.
Uh-huh.
Try to get across the field. To get them. All
right. Sounds good.
All right.
Here, hold on a second, man. Hold on a second. I got to move these shells to my front pocket. They keep pulling my pants down. Right when I was starting to get lazy and hold my gun wrong. Yeah. Come on, you gotta be kidding me. Don't move. Don't move. He's headed up the hedgerow. Man, I almost got a shot on him. He was just barely peeking out. Another chipmunk. Another chipmunk. Wow. Lots of chipmunks. There's like 3 in front of me. The one to the right.
Okay, so tree, tree, tree. The one in the middle. It's like halfway up. See him?
Put it right on him. Whoa! Did he fall? I'm gonna go look for my squirrel.
He's literally right here. See?
Oh.
Dark blob I'm in looking. That apple tree where that bird just took off.
Right there?
Yeah.
You wanna get the other one?
I don't know where it is. Go ahead, shoot.
I hit him. I don't care if he crawled off. Where'd he go? You gotta be kidding me, man. These squirrels made of steel or something? Sure. So we're gonna hike back up this edge here for rabbits, then sit in a spot for squirrel for a little while, and then we're gonna go get something to eat and go home for a little bit to Patrick's home. From there on, I don't know. Oh man, well we did the 5 fields or whatever, now we're just hiking back, both pretty tired. Taking a break here, sitting looking for squirrels. Oh man, we walked so far. Whew.
Figure we can go get some food and then clean the rabbits up and just relax for a while. Let's hunt our way out, see if we can get any squirrels or anything.
Sounds good to me. There's one. Patrick got him. I definitely nicked him. Where's the other one now? I don't see it. Very nice. Let me get a little closer. It's a wide angle lens. Beauty. Good deal. Nice gray squirrel. He might have holed up, man. This is a big tree. Yeah, you're sneaky. This walk wasn't nearly as bad as when there was a foot of snow last time I was here. It was just brutal. Alright, we're turning around here because Patrick said he saw a cat frozen in the snowbank.
You're gonna get out and look at it.
Need a close-up of this for your adventure. What the heck? How did that happen? Dude, that's terrible.
That's a big ass cat.
Wow.
Is that a bobcat?
No. No, dude. Okay. That's a house cat.
That's a big ass cat, though.
Yeah. That's gross and sad and awkward. Patrick's squirrel, Patrick's two rabbits, and my rabbit shot in the wrong end. I think we're done for the day. We're gonna clean these guys up and order some Chinese and stuff and just relax. We hiked, how many miles do you think we hiked, Patrick?
Today, probably about
five or six miles, yeah. Wasn't terribly hard because there's little snow, but still whipped our butt a little bit.
We're gonna process up some bunnies, show you how I do it. Pinch the fur here, make a small incision. Skin comes off pretty darn easy. So the best way to clean these up is just cold tap water, obviously. Just make sure that there's no fur on it, or get as much of it off as you can. Pull that out. Just clean it up. And you pinch right here. Pull up.
Nice trick.
Back through, rinse it off with cold water as best as you can. Make sure not to get any of the little food particles on the rest of the meat. Come in here, pinch the diaphragm, pull it down. Work your fingers up till you get the heart and the lungs.
Mm-hmm.
It'll come out in one chunk. Then to get the rest of the bowels out, you simply put your knife right on the pelvic bone. Split it.
Yep.
Scoop it out with your fingers. And you have one clean rabbit.
Nicely done, man.
And to get any gamey taste out or any flavors you don't want, you can soak it in water, salt water, for about 24 hours. And that'll take all that taste right out, and it also will help tenderize the meat for when you're cooking it.
Cool. Right. Look, I turned it inside out and I made a glove. It fits perfect. It's really warm on the inside, it's all fur.
See if I live up to my expectations of 45 second squirrel skinning.
Sure. I bet you everyone wants to see that.
a man to do that, man. That skin is tough. He's doing that like it's a rabbit. Easy. It takes a lot of friggin' strength to do what he just did. Man, that was fast. Man, jar of rabbit tails and a drawer full of red and gray squirrel tails. That's beautiful, dude. That's awesome. Without the heart. A kiss is not a kiss without the heart. That is a weird fortune, man.
Yeah.
I got shrimp with noodles. Cool. We ordered some Chinese up. Mmm. That's really good. It's time to get going, but Patrick was nice enough to give me all this rabbit to go home with. This is from our hunt today. These ones. Those are from some old hunts of his. I'll see you later, buddy.
All right, man.
It's a good day. Thank you.